watching WFTDA.TV.
They told us to just sell skates online. You won't have any overhead. Put some skulls in your advertising, you'll make a mint. That was never our plan. Our plan was to make a store where all day we are fitting skaters, fixing skates, teaching customers, and putting the best gear on their bodies. Before we put three W's in front of our name, we made sure we had hundreds of happy customers come through our doors. We're not just Derby owned, we're Derby dedicated. Fast Girl Skates.
Wreckingville, St. Louis Gatekeepers,
Bellstar, Rose City Rollers,
Erkin Martin, Denver Roller Dolls,
Gimme Mission, Atlanta Roller Girls,
Meow Mix, Jacksonville Roller Girls,
Kiki Your Ass from Pikes Peak Derby Dames,
Shane Bauer, St. Louis Gatekeepers,
I trust,
I skate,
I am,
Noah Derby.
In the next 30 seconds, I'm going to show you how to control your mental game. Before the game, visualize specifically how you want to be successful. Use a repetitive statement for the power of positive suggestion. Use a simple physical cue during this visualization, like this, this, or this. If you have a bad jam, practice jamnesia. Forget it and focus on the next one. When you need a reset, use your physical cue to return yourself to a relaxed, focused state. Repeat your mantra and get ready to turn your game around. Follow Roller Derby Athletics all through the tournament season for more 30-second game changers.
Welcome back to Charleston, West Virginia. I'm Double H here with my friend Dill Hero.
Hey, how's it going?
What a wacky morning we've had already. We had to change the schedule.
Right.
The first game was actually game number two. That was Mad Rollin' Dolls taking on SoCal. Mad Rollin' Dolls came up on top 242 to 110 over SoCal. So they're going to advance to game number five to play VRDL. But coming up next, we have Jet City taking on Columbia Quad Squad, which was supposed to be the first game of the day.
Yeah, they've had to swap it around, do some serious travel issues all around the board. So if you're going to play the numbers game on trying to figure out who's playing what, you might want to check online and see what the new lineups are going to be. Coming up next, we've got Jet City from Everett, Washington. They are seed 30, seed 8 in this tournament, and they're facing off against the Columbia Quad Squad from Columbia, South Carolina, seed 9 in this tournament and ranked 37 WFTDA.
And whoever wins this one is going to go on to play Rose City in game number 4, which is actually going to happen in game number 6's time slot. So if you're expecting to see Rose City taking on the winner of this game, you're going to want to tune in at 8 o'clock because game number 4 has moved to the 8 o'clock slot, which means the number 4 game, Dill, is going to be ATL taking on Naptown.
Like we said, get your pens and pencils out and do the algebra and the math, which I was never good at, to try to figure out what happened. But they had to do some swapping around and made it happen so it's fair to everybody. And here we are, tournament day one.
So that leaves game number 3, which is going to be Philly taking on Boston at 2 o'clock. That is going to happen as scheduled, thankfully. And then game number 5, VRDL, of course, taking on Mad Rollin' Dolls. That is going to happen at 6 o'clock. So if you're confused, as we are, go to WFTDA.com and you can see the revised times there. There's going to be a press release on it. If you want to go to Facebook, you can visit the WFTDA Facebook page. It should have all the information there as well. We're going to start this game in a minute, and so we're going to take a moment and throw you over to our good friends Mike Checks and Captain Lou.
Well, good day to you Derby fans and addicts. Welcome. I am Mike Checks here with Captain Lou, and you are watching the International 2014 WFTDA Division I Playoffs live from Charleston, West Virginia, brought to you by the Women's Flat Track Derby Association and Chemical Valley Roly Girls.
And as mentioned, we're going to have Jet City Roller Girls, the Bombers, taking on the Columbia Quad Squad Roller Girl All-Stars. Of course, Jet City coming from Everett, Washington, currently ranked 30th in the WFTDA, the 8th seed in this bout. or in this tournament. Mm-hmm. And Columbia, coming from Columbia, South Carolina. And they're the 37th team in the WFTDA and 9 seed for this tournament.
Well, let's get right, pardon me, let's get right to the skating roster for this bout. For Jet City, number 1, Sia Wouldn't Wanna Be Ya. Number 11, Mama Wrecking Ball. Number 12 is Nasty Nikki Nightstick. 13 is Ava Durche. Number 18, Had Enough. 31, Chantilly Cream. 34, Morticia Militia. Number 39, Whoa Nelly. Number 4, Doll Dozer. Number 41, Assaulted Peanut. Number 5, Ivana Hurtcha. Number 6, Beelzebabe. Number 8, Spontaneous Combustia. Number 80, Beethoven's Fist. Number 3, Chick Let's Rock. And 83, Smet. The Jet City Roller Girls in their blue uniforms with white trim, coached by Trailer Trash, Mongo, and Big Papa.
And the all-stars of the Columbia Quad Squad Roller Girls wearing the white in this bout are sending to the bench 003 Agent Cherry Mamer, 007 is Poison Violet, 107 Boston Terror, 14 Joy Wrecker, 25 Chucktown Bruiser, 33 Star Stormer, 333 Fearless Fritz, 420 Amsterdam, 64 Melanoma, 708 Turner Loose, 84 Truck Stop, number 9 Holly Hunter, AK-47 Mal Pacino, B-29 Rosie Riveter, 31 Everyday Hustlin', and 999 Barney Rebel.
Columbia Quad Squad in their white uniforms with black trim are referees, skating referees for this bout. Jason Singer is the head ref. Seer Sin is your inside pack ref. Professor Murder and John Dilks are your jam refs. David Feckham, Divine Intervention, and Jewels and Regulations, your outside pack refs, and Cruel Hand Luke, your alternate for this bout.
And as always, if you have a question for us, you can reach out to us on Twitter using the handle @WFTDALive, and of course the hashtag, the magical hashtag, which allows you to speak to the announcers that you're listening to right now. Talk to the number 2, WFTDA. Brickbats and bouquets are welcome on both sides. Mike checks. I'm expecting a very entertaining game in this bout. Jet City, a very physical team that comes out of the D2 championship last year, and Columbia not unknown for throwing it down on the track as well.
That's right. I do expect to see physical derby out here. Jet City may actually have a little bit of jet lag.
Yeah.
This was alluded to during the pregame, but Jet City landed at Dulles International Airport approximately 12:30 local time this morning. Some of the skaters slept in the airport. Some of them got a hotel. And they arrived here at the venue about an hour and a half ago. So it's going to be interesting to see if there is any lag to start their gameplay this morning.
Yeah, I mean, and when you listen to the WFTDA playoffs, you will hear the announcers talk about exhaustion as the tournament goes on. Rarely do we talk about it on the very first bout that they play in the tournament. But yeah, Jet City, an uphill battle against travel fatigue. We'll have to see how it plays out against Columbia, but things are lined up against them early on in this game already.
That's right. It looks like all of the skaters going to start right in front of the jam line for this first jam. We've got Whoa Nelly wearing the star for Jet City.
That is 007 Poison Violet wearing the star for Columbia. Poison Violet, a very vibrant and she's an active jammer. You will be entertained by her, I guarantee you, if you have not seen her play yet.
All right, we are about to get things underway.
Magical 5 seconds are indicated. Mike checks, take us away.
I'm going to let Whoa Nelly try and take us away. She coming up against the Quad Squad blockers in the backfield. We already have a high block penalty. That going against Sia Wouldn't Want to Be It for Jet City. She reports to the notorious RED penalty box. Lead jammer goes to the Quad Squad.
Yeah, quick lead jammer for Poison Violet heading to the notorious RED penalty box on a multiplayer block is number 33, that Star Stormer. A little bit more blocker space for Wonelli to move with checks.
Nasty Nikki Nightstick moving up front, trying to keep Poison contained in the pack on her first scoring pass. Jet City now clears on their initial pass. Whoa, Nelly, 5 points picked up by the Quad Squad.
Quad Squad got to be happy with that first jam. They get Poison Violet out there, pick up the full five. Now on the other side, Jet City did get their jammer out. We're able to keep it down to one single scoring pass. So minor victories on both sides, but on the scoreboard, it is 5-0 for Columbia. Columbia in white, 0 for Jet City. They are in the blue. 29 minutes remaining in the first half of this bout. On the Fast Girls Skates, jammer line is number 64, Melanoma. She's going up against Ava Derchi for Jet City.
Looks like Star Stormer starting this jam in the penalty box for the Quad Squad. See, you wouldn't want to be out of the penalty box now for Jet City. Pack working its way through turns 1 and 2, and Jet City picking up their first lead jammer of this bout.
Caught on her tail is Melanoma. So that's going to be a quick call off. Double fist in the air. Mike checks means no points on the board. Score remaining 5-0 in this bout early on. Two jams in. And, of course, the bills get paid because the sponsors help us out. So Notorious R.E.D. Gear Deodorant, 100% natural ingredients to punch out 100% of your gear stench. Check them out at NotoriousRED.com. And on the Fast Girl Skates, jammer line is going to be Joy Wrecker for Columbia and Ivana Hercha for Jet City.
Both teams at full strength to start this third jam of the bout. Ivana Hercha tries to go through the middle, moving now to the inside, kind of forced there by the Quad Squad. She goes out as she enters turn one, goes down to a knee, recovers. Again, Nasty Nikki Nightstick up front for Jet City, and Columbia Quad Squad escapes the pack with lead jammer. Joy Wrecker clear on her initial pass.
So two lead jammers for Columbia, one so far for Jet City.
Nasty Nikki Nightstick trying to contain up front. She working with Spontaneous Combustia, but that is a 5-point scoring pass for the Quad Squad as Ivana Hercha now clear the pack on her initial pass for Jet City. See, you wouldn't want to be reporting again to the Notorious R.E.D. penalty box. That is her second penalty early this bout, Lou.
Nice draw back by Chantilly Cream. Keeps the points on the second pass to only 2. Mike checks. 7 points in that jam for Columbia. They now roll up to 12. Jet City remaining at 0. 26 minutes and 50 seconds remaining in the first half. Again, on the Fast Girl Skate start line is Poison Violet for Columbia. And that's Beethoven's Fist for Jet City.
Beethoven's Fist, this her first jam early on here in this bout, looking to put points on the board for Jet City. Poison getting knocked to the outside or inside by Beelzebabe. Beethoven's Fist trying to work over the front of the pack. She gets pushed to the inside, now recycled to the entry of turn one. Poison now working over the front of the pack, two left to beat up front. Jet City looking to contain, and again, Quad Squad through with lead jammer.
Yeah, that initial hit was assisted by Had Enough, number 18 from Jet City. Nice pack work, but they could not keep Poison Violet in there. She's ready to score, Mr. Checks.
Beethoven's Fish pushed to the outside just as she saw the light of day, although Poison Violet taking a big hit as she enters turn one as well. Remember, Beethoven's Fish still working on her initial pass for Jet City. Poison Violet already working on a scoring pass for the Quad Squad. Offense in the form of Had Enough, unfortunately knocks their jammer to the inside. And Poison Violet through. That is another 5-point scoring pass for the Quad Squad.
Yeah, the Quad Squad defense really locking down on Beethoven's Fist, being able to contain her. Poison Violet coming around again.
Poison Violet pushed to the inside. Beethoven's Fist still working on her initial pass, and a whip through turn two. Poison Violet again clears the pack. That's 15 points so far this jam.
That physicality from the Quad Squad exerting itself in this jam. Beethoven's Fist looking absolutely exhausted. At the back of the pack, she's getting drawn back again. Mike checks.
Beethoven's Fist having a really rough go this jam. Poison Violet up front working against Had Enough. Out of play being whistled. Poison Violet pushes through. And it looks like Had Enough may be headed to the Notorious R.E.D. penalty box as is Turner loose for the Quad Squad. Morticia Militia knocked to the inside in turn two. And Poison Violet through the pack, another 5 points, Lou.
That is 20 points on the jam. Columbia able to extend their lead to 32-0 over Jet City. We mentioned that Jet City may feel a bit jet-lagged coming into this from all the travel fatigue. It appears that they're having difficulty getting their jammer out of the pack, especially in that jam. They're going to send Mama Wrecking Ball. She had an excellent spring roll when I saw her there. We'll see if Jammer of Size can do something against this Columbia Quad Squad. She's going against Melanoma for Columbia.
Again, Quad Squad, as they've done this bout, setting up right in front of the jam line. However, this time it's Mama Wrecking Ball through. Lee Jammer going to Jet City for just the second time this bout. However, hot on her wheels, Melanoma from the Quad Squad. Quad Squad blockers pushing themselves to the front right now, trying to protect their points, Lou.
Yeah, nice racing going on in front of the pack. Good position work.
Notorious R.A.D. penalty box empties out. Both teams going to start the next jam at full strength, and we have another 0-0 jam.
I think that's a good call-off, though, by Mama Wrecking Ball. She got lead jammer. She's a little bit of a momentum shift. Yes, Columbia got their jammer out. Tiny bit of a race. Just get the legs under them. They've got to get that travel weariness done, but you change things up. I like the call-off, but I like the effort that she put out there. Whoa, Nelly taking the star against Joy Wrecker on that fast girl skate start line.
Blockers physical to start this jam. Whoa, Nelly trying to work in the backfield. Joy Wrecker making her way through the pack, although good containment up front by the Jet City blockers. Whoa, Nelly runs into that, then takes a spill as she enters turn two. Joy Wrecker pushed to the inside just at the exit of turn two. And whoa, Nelly through the pack. Lead jammer. That's two in a row now for Jet City.
Yeah, nice little hop on Apex. Jet City starting to find their footing out there. Mike checks. Not something I did not expect.
No, and Jet City now looking to put their first points on the board. Whoa, Nelly goes to the outside. One left to beat up front. She goes down, recovers. That is number 333, Fearless Fritz, with the defense up front. And then nice cycle up by the Jet City blockers. That was knocking Chucktown Bruiser to the outside. She has the star hidden, and now she's going to put it on as she is headed to the notorious R.E.D. penalty box.
Yeah, Chucktown Bruiser is a big hitter. She had the stripe. She took the star, committed the forearm, and now a track cut, Mike checks. A track cut on Wonelli.
That was drawn by Joy Wrecker, who started this jam as the jammer for the Quad Squad.
Nice multi-purpose work out there by Joy Wrecker.
So now as Whoa Nelly takes the seat in the notorious R.E.D. penalty box, Chucktown Bruiser, now the jammer for the Quad Squad, returns to play.
And I believe I gave Columbia too many points on the previous scoring information. Score is actually 27-0 right now, and there goes Chucktown Bruiser completing that initial pass, Mike checks.
That's right. Whoa, Nelly now out of the penalty box for Jet City. She is about to enter turn three, goes to the outside. Fritz cycling up. Good containment by the Quad Squad as Chuck comes through, gets knocked to the inside. And Chucktown Bruiser.
3 points for Chucktown Bruiser, 5 points for Wonelli.
And Chucktown Bruiser was whistled for a low block penalty at the very end of that jam.
Yeah, I thought I had heard the whistle. Low block sensor two. The notorious R.E.D. penalty box. S1 Helmets. Be a lifer, get a lifer. S1Helmets.com. 29-5. So Jet City has broken the goose egg there on the scoreboard now.
That is number 13, Ava Durche, jamming for Jet City, starting in a power jam. However, the Columbia Quad Squad with all four blockers on the track. Now Nasty Nikki Nightstick up to play offense on the inside. The rest of the Jet City blockers started to follow suit. That is Chantilly Cream now up to play some offense, and Ava Durche through lead jammer Jet City.
Chucktown Bruiser standing, the notorious R.E.D. penalty box, a power jam about to come to an end, Mike checks.
And that looks like Holly Hunter that just reported to the notorious R.E.D. penalty box for the Columbia Quad Squad. Ava Durche trying to get around Poison Violet at the front, does get recycled. She is on a scoring pass for Jet City. Ava Durche through, 5 point scoring pass, Jet City. Chucktown Bruiser trying to get through the front of the pack, picks up some blocking from Poison Violet, who's now going to receive a cap pass. She is clear on her initial pass. Ava Durche knocked to the outside of the far straightaway. Calls off the jam. Picks up two more points. Jet City now on a little scoring run there, Lou.
Yeah, 12-2 run for Jet City over the past two jams. 7 points in that jam for Jet City. So they are starting to roll their way back into this game, only down by 17, 19 minutes and 10 seconds remaining in the first half.
Well, and speaking of roll, this action brought to you in part by Rydell Skates. Unmatched quality, unmatched performance. Learn more at RydellSkates.com.
And we've got ourselves an official timeout. A little bookkeeping going on by the Stripes. Columbia Quad Squad obviously coming out very strong at the beginning of this game. We're only 11 minutes in, so the beginning was the very beginning of this game. But now Jet City's starting to roll, and this is what I expect from the D2 champions as well. They have shown that they can play at a high level. We saw that all last year. We saw during this season that they played a whole bunch of games and performed well. This is a big test for them. But I think they come in as 8 seed. They are the favored in this bout.
Well, and back when regionals was a thing here in the WFTDA, Jet City did make it to Westerns on two separate occasions. So they're definitely used to being on this stage, so to speak. This official timeout is in part due to track repair that is going on right now.
This is true. Yeah, and Columbia was in the Asheville tournament last year. They lost a ninth-place game, which means they came in 10th. Now, to be fair, they were seeded 10th, and they were also part of that little bump where, once again, the Ole Rollers did not participate in the playoffs last year, so they were the 41 team coming in. So that was their first experience in the playoffs. It was a tough experience for Columbia. I think they hoped that people would stand and swing with them, and a lot of people were using a lot more strategy against them. I think Columbia has learned a lot over the past year, and we're seeing that. I think this is a great first game for both these teams.
Well, one of the things that I've noticed at this tournament that I have seen in previous tournaments, but you see it there on your screen there, is, or you did just a moment ago, where the team has sort of created a semicircle for the next lineup that is to go out to allow for easier communication. I like that trend.
Me too, and it tends to distract you from what's happening on the track, lets you focus on what's going to happen on the next jam, and the next jam is underway with Ivana Hercia on the line against Melanoma.
Melanoma going to the outside, door shut quickly though. Pack now just approaching the pivot line. Ivana Hercia goes to the outside. Keeps herself standing on her skates. Rest of the pack, though, catches up to her. And Pack fast coming into turn three. Now exiting turn four. Still no lead jammer. Melanoma, though, accelerating in the front straightaway. She clears. Lead jammer goes to the quad squad.
Yeah, and Ivana Hercia just getting pushed out as she was coming around the turn. She had to reset. And here comes Melanoma on a scoring pass.
Nasty Nikki Nightstick, a little bit of offense and a jammer push, helping to get her jammer through the pack on her initial pass. Melanoma working over the inside, now dancing to the outside for the quad squad. Laid out by Nasty Nikki Nightstick, calls off the jam, but not before picking up 3 points.
Laid out by Nasty Nikki Nightstick is a phrase that is oft used when calling Jet City. She is a force of nature out there and a terror for jammers pretty much everywhere. 3 points on that jam for Columbia. Now at 32, Jet City remains at 12, 17 minutes, 50 seconds remaining in the first half. Beethoven's Fist taking the star, going up against Joy Wrecker on that fast girl skate start line.
Joy Wrecker immediately going to the inside, now changes and goes to the out. Great lateral movement, tries to find room to work on the inside, getting a little bit of offensive help from Turner Luce. Oh, big hit. Nasty Nikki Nightstick drops her to the inside. Direction of play penalty for her efforts. And Joy Record, thought she had room on the inside to clear. She did not, going to be recycled again. Beethoven's Fist working the front of the pack. Nice little hop. Did not stay in bounds, though. Track cut penalty. Power jam quad squad. And Joy Wrecker trying to get around Spontaneous Combustion at the front of the pack. She does lead jammer quad squad.
Yeah, tough break for Beethoven's Fist. She had a really tough first jam when she was out there jamming. Almost made her way through. Picked up that track cut. And the power jam starts rolling full force now.
Delayed offense there by the quad squad. Works in their favors. Joy Wrecker clears the pack on a 5-point scoring pass. Timing is everything.
It is indeed. Spontaneous Combustion trying so hard to keep her in there. She's going to get another shot here as here comes Joy Recker again.
Spontaneous combustion, definitely not afraid to hit an opposing jammer in the least. Very physical player and very good at that. Joy Recker pushing through the front of the pack. She clears. Right behind her was Beethoven's fist, but Hunter shutting the door on her. That was a five-point scoring pass for the quad squad as Beethoven's fist knocked to the outside of turn four.
Holly Hunter picking up a forearm. That is her second trip to the Taurus RD penalty box in this half.
Joy Recker already around the track and engaging on another scoring pass, having to contend with Nasty Nikki Nightstick in the backfield. Nice drop of the bridge there by Spontaneous Combustia. Joy Recker still working on another scoring pass for the quad squad. Both jammers reset. And now Joy Recker being told to just hold off was killing time on the penalty there. Jam ends.
Yeah, no additional points. Interesting strategy on the part of Columbia, deciding that they didn't need to go for any more points on that jam. 30 points is the gap. 42-12 is the score in favor of Columbia. Timeout for Jet City. Timely timeout, I think. Mr. Checks.
That's right. Trail of Trash calling that timeout. I originally thought he had signaled for an official review, but since he's not out there talking to the officials, my guess is that didn't actually happen.
We should show some love for Adam Wheels. Adam is a proud partner of the WFDDA for 6 years running. You can visit them at atomwheels.com. So again, 30 points separate these teams. Jet City able to score their points over two jams. Back in jams 6 and 7, they have been having trouble getting their jammer out of the pack again. The Columbia defense has been very strong out there. It's been very physical in those packs. Beethoven's fist has been shut down twice now. You have to wonder, it's still early on in the game, but sometimes you have to start thinking about, are you going to throw an alt jammer in for your jammer rotation? Are you going to shrink your jammer rotation? I know they're suffering from the travel fatigue and everything, but this is the playoffs, and if you lose, you go into the consolation bracket. If you win, you at least get a shot to play against VRDL later tonight at 6 p.m. So you know you want to win your first game.
Well, and the interesting thing is Trail of Trash probably trying to get the team to reset, clear their head, and see if they can't right the ship here. They're down by 30, but as you mentioned, it is still early. That's Mama Wrecking Ball out there jamming for Jet City opposite Poison Violet. Poison Violet has had a lot of success against Jet City so far this bout.
Yeah, Poison Violet so far has already picked up 20 points of the 42 Columbia has.
Poison Violet able to shake off a couple of attempted hits from Hattie Nuff. Clears the pack. Lead jammer going to the quad squad. Mama Wrecking Ball trying to fight her way through the backfield. Now up front. And she is clear for Jet City, but giving up about half the track to Poison Violet.
But even getting your jammer out has to be seen as a small victory for Jet City. They've got to be happy that there's not going to be multiple passes. Not even one complete pass, Mike checks. Only 2 points held on that jam.
No, but that was some great offense there by Boston Terror to help the quad squad pick up those couple of points before before calling off the jam.
Score is now 44-12, Columbia over Jet City. Again, Columbia in the white, Jet City in the blue. 14 minutes and 24 seconds remaining in the first half. On the Fast Girl Skate start line is Woe Nelly for Jet City and Melanoma for Columbia.
Jet City's blockers starting up on the pivot line to start this jam. Looks like we've got a track cut penalty. That is going against Melanoma. Woe Nelly now going to be in a power jam for Jet City. Woe Nelly with one to beat up front. Now two. Columbia quad squad blockers cycling up nice. That's Holly Hunter up front in the very front that Woe Nelly is trying to push through. Woe Nelly still stays in bounds. Mal Pacino tried to knock her out, and now lead jammer going to Jet City's Woe Nelly.
That was a nice stretch defense by Columbia trying to keep her in the pack. Woe Nelly finally getting out, but killing almost the entire penalty, Mike checks.
Each team one blocker short now, and Melanoma standing in the Notorious RAD penalty box. She will be released momentarily. Woe Nelly clears the pack. That was a five-point scoring pass as Melanoma rejoins play in turn four.
And again, this is Melanoma's initial pass, so still advantage to Jet City.
I like the offense that the quad squad blockers play for their jammers. Some nice work there, as you see Mal Pacino doing it right there from the front. A little bit of inverse offense as Wonelli clears on another 5-point scoring pass for Jet City.
Yeah, once again, another nice drawback by Spontaneous Combustion, enabling Jet City to crawl back into this bout.
Melanoma clears on her initial pass for the quad squad. Wonelli fighting up front, calls off the jam, did pick up 4 more points.
So a 14-point jam for Wonelli on the back of that power jam. That's going to put Jet City at 26 to Columbia's 44, 18 points separating them now, Mike Checks.
Well, and you know, Lou, if you're going to call a timeout in the first half, those are the results that you want to see coming out of that timeout. Nice job by Trailer Trash. Nice job by Jet City skaters responding. Let's see if they can keep that going in the next jam.
On the Fast Girl Skate Star line, Eva Derchi going up against Joy Wrecker.
Joy Wrecker again. Great lateral movement, started to the out, moves all the way back to the in. She's now trying to go through the middle. Ava Derchi at the back of the pack takes a jersey whip, as does Joy Wrecker. She is clear. Lead jammer goes to the quad squad, but Ava Derchi right behind her. Jammer's mixing it up a little bit. Jet City blockers moving up to the front of the pack now. Joy Wrecker keeping Ava Derchi contained, keeping the roll slow. Pack, though, looking like they're trying to catch up to the jammers.
The pack is hustling and the jammers are not. They are actually catching up to the jammers.
That is a fast pack. Jammers, again, very slow. It's like this is a time kill right now. And that may be it, as Columbia Quad Squad had one blocker in the notorious RAD penalty box.
Yeah, it looked like they were trying to get Chucktown Bruiser out of the box. Joy Wrecker able to play that jammer-on-jammer defense. She's going to call it off, Mike Checks, with no points. As a coach, I don't really mind that strategy, though. You are winning by 18. You don't really have an advantage in that jam. The only disadvantage you have is the fact you have your blocker in the penalty box. If you can get your jammer to play jammer-on-jammer defense, slow it down, kill the 30 seconds, keep the pack moving so no points can be scored by either side, and get it back to 5-on-5, I like that.
Well, and that's, you and I were talking about that during the last bout, is that whatever you can do to stop a penalty parade, or in this case, stop one from even starting, is a positive thing. Ivana Hurtcha, jammer of record for Jet City, opposite Poison Violet to start this jam. Poison Violet already out front, working against the Jet City blockers at the front of the pack. That looked like a penalty being leveled against Spontaneous Combustia for Jet City. And Ivana Hurtcha through on the inside. Rail lead jammer goes to Jet City.
And Poison Violet being isolated. She's got one to beat, but it's Nasty Nikki Nightstick, and that one is not easy.
Nice shot by Chantilly Cream to pop up and lay the bridge down for Nasty Nikki Nightstick. Meanwhile, Ivana Hurtcha back in the pack, takes a big hit, pushes her out of turn one, calls off the jam from the floor.
Looking for the points. Gonna get some consultation on the outside. That was Holly Hunter. She's got a background in artistic skating. 2 points for Jet City at the end of that jam, 44 to 26, 28, once they adjust it.
And
hopefully, there we go, 28. Yeah, Holly Hunter has a background in artistic skating. She's a nightmare out there, and sometimes you don't see her coming and you get laid out to the outside.
All right, for Columbia, that is number 64, Melanoma, jamming for Jet City, number 80, Beethoven's Fist. Both teams starting with blockers in the penalty box, 2 for the quad squad, 1 for Jet City. And Beethoven's Fist through the pack, lead jammer goes to Jet City.
That's got to be quite a relief for Beethoven's Fist after the first couple jams she's had in this game. Now with lead jammer in control. And Melanoma out of the pack as well, Mr. Checks.
Nice job by Chucktown Bruiser playing the offense to spring her jammer on that initial pass. Beethoven's Fist takes a big hit in the first apex. Goes down, calls off the jam, and no score in that one.
No score, but she did get lead jammer. She was able to keep Columbia at the 44. They currently stand Jet City still at 28. 16 points remains the differential with 8.5 minutes remaining in the first half. Roller Bones and Bones Bearings make for a winning combination. Find out all about them at rollerbones.com. On that Fast Girl Skate start line is going to be Mama Wrecking Ball for Jet City, and she's going against Joy Wrecker for Columbia.
Columbia Quad Squad starting with a one blocker advantage. Jet City Blockers again starting at the pivot line as we saw them do earlier this bout. Mama Wrecking Ball frees herself. Lead jammer going to Jet City. Chantilly Cream up to play defense for Jet City. Could not contain Joy Wrecker, who's clear on her initial pass, but gives up about half the track to Mama Wrecking Ball.
Chantilly Cream doing some nice positional blocking at the front. Not afraid to get physical, but doing a good job of controlling that pack. The jam's going to get called off. Mama Wrecking Ball picking up 3 points for Jet City. 31-44 is the score.
I really like Mama Wrecking Ball earning her namesake as she went into that pack right there. She's just like, I'm not going to bother pushing this. I'm going to hit this as hard as I can legally. I'm going to take my points. I'm going to call off the jam.
And you know, the Columbia blockers are the kind of blockers that are willing to take those hits too. So she knows that she can get in there. Columbia's been held scoreless for 5 jams now by Jet City. They had only scored in 1 jam since that timeout. The timeout working wonders for Jet City.
Well, Poison Violet now the jammer of record for the quad squad, and she has had a great bout so far. That is Woe Nelly once again for Jet City. She got knocked down just as the jam started and gets recycled in the front straightaway.
Doll Dozer with a multiplayer block. She's going to free up the pack a bit.
And that is Poison Violet, lead jammer for the quad squad. Woe Nelly still working on her initial pass. She now clears. But Poison Violet already putting points on the board for the quad squad. And she clears the pack on a 4-point scoring pass and calls off the jam, Lou.
So Columbia finally able to break that scoring drought. 4 points for the Columbia quad squad All-Stars. 48 is their total, 31 for Jet City. 6.5 minutes remaining in this first half. Our skates can beat up your skates. Antic Skate Boots at greenmonster.com. That's Green Monster. Take away all the vowels and you'll find them. On the Fast Girl Skate Star Line is going to be the Melanoma for Columbia and Eva Derche.
Quad Squad starting short, 1 blocker. Jet City starting short, 2. Nasty Nikki Nightstick exit hit in turn 1. However, whistled for a penalty for that hit. Melanoma is clear of the pack, but not your lead jammer. Ava Derche just beating her out. Lead jammer goes to Jet City. Spontaneous combustion in that really unfortunate role where she was the only blocker on the track for a second for Jet City.
Yeah, and we have ourselves a jammer race that's gone into jammer on jammer defense.
Well, and we saw Quad Squad do this earlier. Maybe trying to empty the penalty box once again.
Yeah, 1 blocker aside in there. Fearless Fritz for Columbia. Nasty Nicky Nightstick for Jet City.
It looks like somebody may have lost an armband down in turn 4. Both jammers still trying to catch up to the pack. Melanoma, great defense against Ava Derche. And Ava Derche calls off the jam. Again, no score.
Again, no score. 1 full minute in that jam. Lots of jammer on jammer interaction. But no points on the board. 15 points remain as the deficit for Jet City. 48-31. 4 minutes, 50 seconds remaining in the first half. On the Fast Girl Skate Start Line, Ivana Hercha for Jet City. And Joy Wrecker for Columbia.
Looks like we're going to start 4-on-4 in the pack. First time we've been able to do that in a while. Joy Wrecker trying to push the Jet City blockers up front. That is Ivana Hercia working in the backfield against the quad squad. A little bit of inverse offense now being played. That by number 34, Morticia Militia for Jet City. Unfortunately for her, does not free Ivana Hercia. Joy Wrecker still working against the front of the pack. And that's Morticia Militia now who dropped the bridge. Number 4, Doll Dozer to the penalty box for Jet City. Joy Wrecker declared lead jammer overtaken by Ivana Hercia, and that jam called to its conclusion.
Yeah, that was a multiplayer block on Doll Dozer. It is her 3rd penalty in this half. Not terrible danger on that, but the one you have to watch is number 12, Nasty Nikki Nightstick. She has picked up 4 penalties in this half, heading into that danger zone with only 3.5 minutes in the first half, and she's going back on the track, so... She's going to have to play clean if she wants to stay in this game, Mr. Checks.
Nasty Nikki Nightstick has been involved in a number of jams already this bout. On the jam line, that's Beethoven's Fist and Poison Violet, your jammers of record this jam. Poison Violet already up to the front of the pack. Jet City blockers separate themselves from the rest of the pack. Nasty Nikki Nightstick tries to drop the bridge, but Poison Violet through Lead Jammer Quad Squad.
Yeah, Poison Violet, 4 out of 6 Lead Jammer statuses, 26 points so far in this half.
Beethoven's Fist through the pack, clear on her initial pass. Poison Violet already picking up points, finds room to work on the inside, clears the pack, does not call off the jam though, waits it out, then calls off the jam.
Yeah, looking right at her bench, waiting for the cue. As the Jet City Jammer approached the back, the hands went to the hips, maximizing the time to come off the clock. Nice work on Columbia, really, really manipulating the clock. As the coach side of me is excited by the work that they're doing on the bench. I really like the way that they're max. I mean, they only have a 21-point lead. It's not like they're nursing a huge lead, but they're making the most of it, Mike checks.
Right, no, it's been interesting time management on behalf of the quad squad. Back to the action on the track. That's Melanoma jamming for Columbia. Mama Wrecking Ball for Jet City. And Mama Wrecking Ball through the pack. Lead Jammer going to Jet City. However, Melanoma just finds room on the inside. She clears on her initial, giving up about a third of the track to Mama Wrecking Ball.
Mama Wrecking Ball batting 750 so far for Lead Jammer status.
Quad Squad cycling their blockers up to the front of the pack. Nice point protection, and there was no score in that jam.
Yeah, we see the final fist from Professor Murda, who indicates no points. Yeah, Mama Wrecking Ball running into the back of her own blockers, picked off a skate and fell to the ground as a result. Looks like we're going to get an official review. And there's the whistles. Yes, it's going to be Columbia taking the official review. And this official review will be brought to you by PrintcoGraphics.com. Lead the pack with new UV ink printing at PrintcoGraphics.com.
Well, Lou, while we've got a moment here, our score, 52-31, minute 31 seconds left to play here in the first half. That's only a combined 83 points between these two teams. We have played almost 30 minutes of Derby. This seems like a really low-scoring bout.
It is a really low-scoring bout, but again, I think it has a lot to do with that time manipulation, the clock manipulation, the whole TARDIS effect that Columbia is managing to exert upon this game, stretching out jams that normally would get called off, making the clock last longer when they have control on the track. And that's allowing them to keep the score where they want it.
Well, and early on, Jet City had picked up 3 lead jammers, probably in the first half dozen, 8 jams or so, and were held scoreless in those jams. And then, of course, the jams that you mentioned where jammer defense was being played and basically killing penalties, that led to a lot of clock burn in this first half.
Yeah, it really did. And Columbia's been able to hold Jet City scoreless for the last 4 jams after that nice run that Jet City had put together. We're going to get some clarification momentarily. We do have an announcer ref who is Cruel Hand Luke out of Rocky Mountain, I believe. And he's going to tell our producer, who happens to be Lightning Slim, if you were watching the first game, you would have heard him, doing double duty in this game.
That's right.
But we will get on the Fast Girl Skate start line. Wonelli in blue for Jet City and Joy Wrecker in white for Columbia.
We'll have Lightning Slim jump in here and give you that clarification here as soon as this jam is concluded. Wonelli pushed to the inside by Boston Terror. However, Boston Terror picking up a forearm penalty for that effort. Wonelli now reset, as is Joy Wrecker in the backfield. Wonelli working up front, one to beat. She clears Lead Jammer going to Jet City.
And a track cut caused by Chantilly Cream has turned this into a power jam. Jet City ready to roll.
Wonelli getting some offense in the backfield. One to beat up front, she clears. That was number 333, Fearless Fritz, trying to contain. 5-point scoring pass for Jet City. Trayla Trash telling her to keep going from the sideline. A whip into offense for Jet City. Whoa, Nelly takes a hit from Holly Hunter. That's Fritz up front. Chucktown Bruiser trying to hold back Wonelli. 5-point scoring pass for Jet City. And Jet City holding a goat in the backfield. They now give that up as they get ready to play defense with Joy Wrecker returning to play. Wonelli into the pack once again on another scoring pass for Jet City. Joy Recker pushed to the outside. She does have the cap in her hand and now gets dropped big. That was a huge hit there.
Yeah, I would see it wouldn't want to be a living up to her name.
Jet City getting physical now. Wonelli pushed to the outside at turn two. Gonna have to reset. Spontaneous combustion laying down the hits up front for Jet City.
That was a crazy last jam of the half, Mike checks.
Indeed Jets, it was.
Jet City puts 15 points up on the power jam, closes the game to a six-point gap.
Wow.
Columbia at 52, Jet City at 46.
Definitely been a streaky first half of these two teams, Lou.
It has. And I think we saw, I'm in that last jam, I really feel we saw what we're going to see a lot more in the second half. Jet City getting really physical in that second half, or that last jam. And that's really what they need to bring into the second half. Columbia's done a good job of keeping the game physical on their side of things.
Right.
Jet City needs to amp it up a bit more. And, you know, really nice work causing that track cut. But
well, and it looked like that physical play may have caught the quad squad off guard since we really hadn't seen that level of physical play from Jet City. You know, we saw it here and there sprinkled in. But in that last jam, very apparent.
So again, you are watching the International 2014 WFDDA Division I playoffs from Charleston, West Virginia. This is the Columbia Quad Squad All-Stars versus the Jet City Bombers, 52-46. Captain Lou Albamo.
Mike checks.
We'll see you after the half.
When DRD first started, we created shiny helmets and used a ton of glitter that just got everywhere. Glitter is fun and hardcore. I've learned that it's hardcore. You know, it's an honor to be able to wear this jersey and be able to represent this team who has done so much to impact the sport and still, you know, continues to impact the sport going forward.
My name is Midge Wilhelm. I skate with the Denver Roller Dolls, and S1 is part of my uniform.
Las Vegas living room in 2005, the first shop ever dedicated to roller derby, and has since grown into this 2,000 square foot mecca in San Diego, where we stock everything for our sport. Need help? With a combined on-track experience of over 24 years and still playing, we test everything we sell, and we're happy to share that experience and knowledge with you. So contact us, SinCityskates.com.
We'll be right back.
Well, fans, welcome back. We are here at halftime of Jet City and Columbia. We are going to get the bout underway here in a few more minutes, Lou.
Yeah, we are, Mike checks. However, we've got numbers to talk about. That big comeback by Jet City at the end, 52-46, only 6 points separating these teams. You got to wonder about penalties. We'll tell you about penalties. Columbia quad squad, 21 trips to the penalty box. Only two jammer penalties, though, so keeping it fairly light on that side.
Well, and for Jet City, 16 trips to the box, two of those by jammers. So we were equal on the jammer penalties, yep. And only five different in the blocker penalties. So that's not a huge difference. As Lou mentioned, late in the first half, Nasty Nicky Nightstick with four. Got to watch out for that. That's Dahl Dozer with three for Jet City.
And over on the Columbia side of the penalty board, you're seeing Chucktown Bruiser and Holly Hunter both with four trips of their own. So that is the danger zone. Only three more trips than the Taurus RD penalty box will send them out of the game. Scoring wise, we've got over on the Columbia side, 30 points for Poison Violet, 19 points for Joywrecker, and 3 for Melanoma. And for Jet City,
that is whoa, Nelly. She has 34 points to her credit, and that in 5 jams. She leads Jet City. Ava Durchie, 7 points in 4 jams. Mama Wrecking Ball, 3 points in 4. And Ivana Hercha, 2 points in 4 jams. Beethoven's Fist, no points so far, has jammed 4 times. Did pick up lead one of those 4 times.
Yeah, Jet City really sticking with that jammer rotation. They've got 5 people running through. The 4 of them have gone 4 times. Bonelli's gone 5 times. That is an area they could tighten up in the second half if they want to look at that. Both Eva Derche and Mama Wrecking Ball batting 750, 75%.
Well, and Lou, one of the things that doesn't get talked about this bout is that if you win, you got to play later today.
Yes,
so,
you do.
So you can't fault either team if they're trying to keep maybe a little energy just hidden in reserve that they may not need for this bout just in, you know, for their bout later today.
That's right. And that bout later today is at 6 p.m. It is against the Victorian Roller Derby League out of Australia. Oh, sorry. It is against Rose City. So they will be playing at 8. 8. What a...
That's right, with our new schedule.
That's a minor right. Problem, yes. That's a long ways away in Rose City, you know.
Well, Rose City will wait patiently.
Yes, indeed. the loser, of course, will be playing against the loser of game number 3. That's going to be Philly versus Boston.
That's going to be a fun bout.
So, if you win or lose, no matter what happens, you're going to have a tough game in your second game. It's just a question of whether you want to have that game today or tomorrow. And I think we all know teams like victory more than defeat.
That is absolutely right. And despite the fact, you know, regardless who their next opponent is going to be, every team wants that W. 6 points separating the two teams, 52-46 as we get ready to start the second half. That is Whoa Nelly on the jam line for Jet City, opposite Poison Violet for the quad squad. And we are underway slowly. A lot of defensive positioning to start this jam. Poison Violet now finding room to work. She gets up to the front part of the pack, trying to push against Jet City. That again, Nasty Nicky Nightstick at the front as Spontaneous Combustia headed to the Notorious RAD penalty box. Looked like a multiplayer block being called against Mal Pacino for the quad squad. And whoa, Nelly, your lead jammer. Poison Violet, though, right behind her.
Yeah, Mal Pacino, Boston Terror, and Truck Stop have been doing a really nice job of holding her back, but she finally found that seam and got through. Poison Violet hot on her tail, though.
Fearless Fritz out of the penalty box for the quad squad. Both jammers again. We see that defensive jamming by Poison Violet there.
Poison Violet yelling for her pack to move forward, preserve the points.
But it's the Jet City blockers who'd moved up the farthest to protect their points. And, we start the second half out with a scoreless jam.
Yep. Nice defense work on both sides. Again, nice strategy on the part of the jammers. See, this is a very chess match-like game. You're not seeing a lot of points put on the board, but very intricate strategies being used by the 8-9 seed at this Charleston tournament.
Thankfully, there's more dancing in this sport than there is in chess,
there
but I
is.
Agree with your point completely.
3-on-3 pack. with Joy Wrecker taking on Eva Derchi, Jet City in blue, Columbia in white.
Joy Wrecker going through the middle, Eva Derchi trying to work on the outside. Starts to go back to the in, but spontaneous combustion. Looks like she's playing a little bit of offense there. But it is Joy Wrecker through the pack. First lead jammer going to the quad squad.
That was a multiplayer block and had enough that helped spring her from the pack.
Eva Derche getting around Chucktown Bruiser. She is clear on her initial pass, but giving up just a little less than half the track to Joy Wrecker, who is already working through the pack on her scoring pass. She goes to the outside. No pack being called. She is clear. Calls off the jam. 4-0 victory for the quad squad in that jam.
Yeah, and a failure to reform at the end of spontaneous combustion sends her to the notorious RED penalty box. Again, nice pack manipulation by both sides. Jet City trying to keep their points up at the front. Columbia trying to keep the pack slow enough so that their jammer can get through. Columbia now at 56, Jet City at 46. 27 and a half minutes remaining in this bout. On the Fast Girl Skate start line is going to be Poison Violet going up against number 5, Ivana Hercha.
Jet City starting with Hattie Nuff and Spontaneous Combustia in the penalty box, and Poison Violet, as she is wont to do, lead jammer going to the quad squad. Ivana Hercha now clears the pack on her initial pass. Poison Violet, room to work, gets by Nasty Nikki Nightstick, moves around Chantilly Cream, and calls off the jam after picking up those 4 points.
Yeah, all 4 points. Columbia now at 60, Jet City at 46. Once again, we will remind you people sitting at home listening to WFTDA.TV or watching us on WFTDA.TV that you can talk to us on the Twitters at the hashtag #TalkTo, that is the number 2, #TalkToWFTDA. Tell us how Mike Checks or Captain Lou Obama are doing. What do you think of this game? Are you cheering for Jet City over Columbia, or do you have a cat that is watching roller derby?
Who's your favorite jammer? Who's your favorite blocker? Let us know. Melanoma wearing the star for the Columbia Quad Squad opposite Beethoven's Fist for Jet City. Beethoven's Fist being held back by Chucktown Bruiser in the backfield. Melanoma recycled to the inside, takes the long route to get back on the track. Beethoven's Fist trying to work against the front of the quad squad defense. That's Chucktown Bruiser and Fearless Fritz up front. Beethoven's Fist trying to get around Chucktown Bruiser, and she is lead jammer, goes to Jet City. However, Melanoma overtakes her. Jet City going to choose to keep this jam going. And then they decide to call it off.
They do indeed decide to call off. No points on that jam. That was a hard-fought lead jammer status, but obviously Beethoven's Fist deciding and the bench deciding not worth spending any more energy. Still lots of time left in this half. 25 minutes and 20 seconds remaining in the game. 60-46, Columbia over Jet City at the moment. Get your league sponsored for product discounts. Email sponsorship at fastgirlskates.com. And on the Fast Girl Skates starter line is Mama Rockin' Ball and Poison Violet.
Mama Wrecking Ball starting on the out, gets knocked down, almost pushed out of the front straightaway. Poison Violet got knocked to the inside and recycled by Sia. Wouldn't want to be a Sia. Tried to knock her out again, but did not get her. Mama Wrecking Ball pushes out front. Lead jammer goes to Jet City.
Poison Violet cycled back by Nasty Nikki Nightstick, and then Truck Stop put a hit on Nasty Nikki Nightstick. Collisions in the pack.
And Mama Wrecking Ball escapes the pack. That is a 5-point scoring pass, a spontaneous combustion to the notorious RED penalty box for a backblock penalty. Poison Violet taking the star off her helmet, clears the pack, and then decides to put the cap back on.
Yeah, a little star stash to escape from that pack.
Mama Wrecking Ball enters the pack, picks up 3 points, and calls off the jam for Jet City as they close the quad squad's lead to 6.
An 8-point jam by Mama Wrecking Ball. It was 6 points at the half. The lead remains 6 points for Columbia. 60-54 is your score. 24 minutes remaining in this game. Again, if you win this, you go on to play against Rose City today. If you lose, you play the loser of Philly versus Boston tomorrow. We've got on the Fast Girl Skate start line, Woe Nelly, number 39 for Jet City, and Joy Wrecker, 14 for Columbia.
Woe Nelly trying to get in a little bit of jammer defense as Joy Wrecker skates past her on the inside rail. Joy Wrecker moved to the inside, resets in the backfield. Woe Nelly now pushing against quad squad blockers at the front of the pack. Joy Wrecker finding room to work on the inside, and she is Clear the pack. Lead jammer goes to the quad squad.
Still stuck at the back. Wonelli as the defense trying to hold strong for Columbia.
A little bit of a goat trap defense there by Jet City. Trying to get Wonelli through the pack. Wonelli still working on her initial pass. Boston Terror doing a good job holding her there. As I say that, Wonelli clears the pack on her initial pass. Joy Wrecker clears the pack on a five-point scoring pass for the quad squad, and she calls off the jam.
Track cut sends Hattie Nuff to the notorious RD penalty box at the end of that jam. That is her third trip. Those points now put Columbia at 65 to Jet City's 54, now under 23 minutes remaining. And man, I gotta tell you, this has been fast packs, it's been hard-hitting packs, it's been madness on the track early on in this tournament. All the blockers and all the jammers and all the announcers, favorites still excited. That's the president, alas insane, writing in on the Twitters.
Well, back to the action on the track. Melanoma, jammer of record for the quad squad. Ava Durche jamming for Jet City. Ava Durche getting moved to the outside. Gonna have to reset. Chantilly Cream tried to stop the blocker from recycling her. Melanoma accelerating through turn two. Lead jammer goes to the quad squad. Looks like we've got a track cut penalty somewhere. And that is going against Ava Durche. As Chantilly Cream also reporting to the notorious RED penalty box, Power Jam Quad Squad.
Yeah, both Jet City skaters picking up track cuts for the important one. Oh, and Nasty Mickey Nightstick now going to the box for a play that is her fifth trip now, my checks.
Melanoma clears the pack, four-point scoring pass for the Quad Squad. And had enough now reporting to the notorious RED penalty box for Jet City. Jet City now on a penalty parade.
Yeah, that's a failure to reform. That is had enough's fourth penalty, and those are five more points for Columbia and Melanoma.
Columbia now a 20-point lead. Penalty box emptying for Jet City. Ava Durche back on the track. Had enough now reporting to the penalty box. It was too full as when she went to report the first time. Nice defense there by Spontaneous Combustia, moving Melanoma to the outside. Ava Durche still working on that initial pass for Jet City, and she is now clear. She gets around Mal Pacino at the front of the pack, but Melanoma picks up four more points and calls off the jam.
Chantilly Cream picking up a low block at the end of that jam. Those 4 points will put Columbia at 78, Jet City at 54. It was a 13-0 jam. Columbia starting to pull away. It is only 24 points. We do have 20 minutes and 30 seconds remaining in the game, so lots of time for people to regroup. But with that penalty parade is dangerous, and as we can see, it's a 3-on-2 pack in favor of Columbia, and we're going to get an official timeout.
Well, it was an official timeout for just a second there. Looks like we had a jam ref checking in with the scoring table real quick. Everybody's back in position, and we're going to continue.
Ivana Hertzia going up against Poison Violet on that fast girl skate start line.
Ivana Hertzia being held up in the backfield by the quad squad. Poison Violet off the line quickly, but she met by the wall of defense from Jet City. Ivana Hertzia going low and to the outside. She finds room and clears the pack. Lead jammer, Jet City. Poison Violet still working through on her initial pass. Takes a jersey whip and clears. Not many skaters on the track right now. Penalty box, though, starting to empty out. Ivana Hertzia into the pack on a scoring pass. She clears on that scoring pass for 4 points and calls off the jam.
Yeah, that two wall at the front of Dolldozer and Assaulted Peanut doing a great work of holding back Poison Violet, allowing the jammer to get out of the pack, pick up those 4 points. Now a 20-point gap, 78-58 in favor of Columbia.
Well, and Dolldozer also kind of screened for her jammer there on that last scoring pass, provided a little bit of a distraction that helped her get through.
On the fast girl skate start line, Beethoven Fist going up against Joy Wrecker.
Beethoven's Fist started with a little bit of defense as Jet City got the real estate just in front of the pivot line to start this jam. 1-2, knocking out Joy Wrecker to the inside as Beethoven's Fist, your lead jammer for Jet City.
Beethoven's Fist with an opportunity now to put her first points of the game up on the board. Very important points to get Jet City back in this, Mike checks.
Beethoven's fist pushed to the outside. Calls off the jam, but does get 3 points for Jet City.
So she's had a tough game so far. She's been beaten up on the track. Jet City keeps putting her out there, gets lead jammer, gets through, picks off 3 points. Now 78-61. You gotta love the stick-to-itiveness of Beethoven's fist.
Well, Lou, as we know, success breeds success, and that may be maybe just enough of a spark for her to where she's able to up her game to another level as we have just over 18 minutes left here in the second half. Mama Wrecking Ball, big hit on Poison Violet to start this jam. Mama Wrecking Ball goes to the outside, stays in bounds, and lead jammer goes to Jet City.
Yeah, that was a monster pop. I don't think Poison Violet was expecting that at all, Mike Checks.
No, due to the look on her face, I don't think she was either. Poison Violet knocked out of bounds in turn one, still working on her initial pass. She runs into the pack, a forearm penalty being called. That going against
Mama Wrecking Ball.
Oh, so now it's Poison Violet finding herself in a power jam for the quad squad.
And this will go the full 2 minutes, as lead jammer was with Mama Wrecking Ball. It's a long, exhausting jam. We'll see how it goes.
Jet City does, at the start of this, have all four blockers on the track. Had enough, thought about going for the hit, instead holds up. Poison Violet clear for 5 points.
Mama Wrecking Ball with points in the bank, as she was on a scoring pass, but she will have to complete it when she comes out.
Doll Dozer hit in the backfield, slows the roll of Poison Violet. Quad squad blockers starting to give Poison Violet some offense now. Jet City blockers reset in front of her. Pack right now in the front straightaway. About to enter turn one. Poison Violet trying to take advantage of the Jet City blockers getting stretched out. Poison Violet slowly rolling. Mama Wrecking Ball out of the penalty box and mixing it up on the track for Jet City. Nice job by Holly Hunter. Does pick up a forearm penalty, but a hit that was effective, knocking Mama Wrecking Ball out.
Mama Wrecking Ball doing a great job of trying to get through, but runs up against Chucktown Bruiser and picked up a track cut. A track cut forced by Chucktown Bruiser.
I don't think she realized that she was the one whistled for that track cut. She is now, as Poison Violet clears the pack on another 5 points. Mama Wrecking Ball did get 4 points there, though.
It looked like Chucktown Bruiser picked up a penalty, and I will just check and see if the stats are correct on that. But if she did, she will be on 6 trips to the notorious RED penalty box, and she has been an absolute force of nature on the track, destroying everyone in her way. Columbia cannot afford to lose her. They have stretched their lead. It's 93-65. There's 15 and a half minutes remaining in this game. It is a power start, and it's Melanoma taking the star for Columbia.
It is a very light pack. Both teams with 2 blockers in the penalty box. Jet City's jammer also in the penalty box. Nasty Nicky Nightstick. Nice last ditch defensive effort. Knocked Melanoma to the infield. That allowed everybody to reset in front of her. She's going to have to take that initial pass for a second time. Jet City blockers recycling to the front. Melanoma being held back, getting some offense now by Boston Terror. The penalty box starting to empty now. In fact, has completely emptied. Mama Wrecking Ball back on the track for Jet City. Takes the cap off, and she passes it. It is now a spontaneous combustion. She has hold of it. She has yet to place it on her helmet. Meanwhile, Melanoma being recycled once again. Now Melanoma taking the cap off. It is in her hand. So nobody wearing a jammer cap right now, Lou.
We don't need jammer caps, do we?
Apparently not.
And yes, we are calling it a cap, people. Feel free to Twitter us at Talk2WFTDA and show your hate.
Boston Terror recycling spontaneous combustion. Spontaneous combustion now with the star on her helmet. Jet City blockers set up front. Truck stop now. Jammer of record for the quad squad. She gets pushed to the inside now and is going to get recycled. That's Mama Wrecking Ball recycling her. Is spontaneous combustion being recycled on the outside?
In a certain level of exhaustion setting in, as the jammer is having to do the star passes, and the star passes are happening to non-typical jammers.
Spontaneous combustion. Thought she had been whistled for a penalty. Instead, it was a no-pass, no penalty. And it looked like number 41, Assaulted Peanut, may have been hurting a little bit there.
Yeah, she ran into Fearless Fritz, who is, again, a very solid blocker out there and did not get the better of the exchange. We should show some more love to people out there, such as Something Inked. We put the pro in promotions. Something Inked has your merch needs covered. Check them out at somethinginked.com. The score now 97-65. That was a 4-0 two-minute jam in favor of Columbia, but absolute exhaustion on the track at the end of that jam.
Joy Record jamming for Columbia. Whoa, Nelly jamming for Jet City. Whoa, Nelly in the backfield, moves now to the front. Quad squad with three blockers up front trying to hold her back. Meanwhile, Joy Record looked like she was going to go to the outside, got held up for a moment. Has accelerated to the front of the pack. Jet City with a four-wall up front, it looked like. As Whoa Nelly goes to the outside, she clears turn two. Lead jammer goes to Jet City.
And that was Agent Cherry Mamer, who was not willing to let her go. Tried to chase her down, but too much speed by Whoa Nelly.
Mal Pacino now looks like she has the star in her hand for the quad squad. She gets knocked to the inside. And Whoa Nelly makes her way through the pack. That's a 5-point scoring pass for Jet City.
This is Jet City trying to claw back as we tick down to the 12-minute mark remaining in this game, and the jam continues.
And that was a track cut by Mal Pacino,
who has the star in her hand. She's going to the Notorious R.E.D. penalty box as a jammer. It's a power jam, Mike checks.
And that is Whoa Nelly clearing the pack for 5 points for Jet City. It seems like every time Jet City gets close, Columbia extends their lead again. As soon as Columbia gets a big enough lead, then Jet City decides to come back. We may be seeing that pendulum swing once again.
Lots of momentum shifts in this game. Whoa Nelly with 10 points already in this jam.
Beelzebabe moving up and providing some offense for Whoa Nelly. Whoa Nelly decides to call off the jam.
4 more points. That'll make it a 14-point jam for Whoa Nelly. That puts Jet City at 79-97 of Columbia. That, my friends, is a palindrome. Something that
we have been
waiting for all game. Radar Wheels palindrome break brought to you by Radar. I saw Ed under Deb's bed. Red nude was I. RadarWheels.com.
I don't know what you just said, but it was brilliant.
It was palindromic anyway.
It was, that is. And it was brilliant that you noticed. Well done, sir. So that is Ava Derche jamming in a power jam for Jet City. It will be a truncated power jam as Mal Pacino was standing in the Notorious R.E.D. penalty box at the start of this jam, and she has now been released. And now a track cut penalty on Ava Derche. Now a power jam for the quad squad.
As we were saying in the last jam, the momentum shifting back and forth in this game, now back in the favor of Columbia.
Jet City's defense going to be tested down this power jam as Mal Pacino goes from in to out. Lead jammer, quad squad.
Power jam continuing as Columbia is picking off blockers as well from Jet City.
Now, Mal Pacino just went down in turn three, and we've seen that once or twice this bout. We saw it about a half dozen times in the last bout as well. Looks like a turn three may have a little bit of slipperiness to it.
Yeah, there's some variation in the grip on this floor, I believe.
Mal Pacino knocked to the inside of turn two, going to reset in the middle of the first apex. Meanwhile, Ava Derche out of the penalty box, back on the track for Jet City. A spontaneous combustion now takes its seat in the Notorious R.E.D. penalty box for Jet City.
Trip number 5 for her, Mike.
Ava Derche pushes out the front of the pack. And the jam called off. 4 more points for the quad squad.
That will get them into the triple digits. The first team to make it there with 9 minutes and 40 seconds remaining in this bout. 101-79 in favor of Columbia. FXX Wheels. Hottest wheels on the market. Quad Star certified cutting edge technology. Check them out at bont.com. We've got some penalty trouble. Chucktown Bruiser is at 6. Holly Hunter at 5. 5 for Spontaneous Combustion. 5 for Nasty Nikki Nightstick.
Poison Violet fights her way through on the inside rail. Lead jammer goes to the quad squad. Ivana Hurtcha out of the pack for Jet City, giving up about a quarter track to Poison Violet.
Poison Violet with 49 points in this game so far for Columbia.
Truck stop. That was a big hit on Morticia Militia to slow the roll of the pack. Then Holly Hunter follows up. Poison Violet picks off 3 points and calls off the jam.
Poison Violet likes to go inverted and check her bench out. And she wasn't paying any attention, has had enough, waited for that moment when she wasn't looking, and then took a run at her. Didn't get too much of her, but Poison Violet's going to have to be careful. The teams are starting to key in on that because she could end up in the suicide seats.
That's right.
104 for Columbia, 79 for Jet City. 8.5 minutes remaining in this game on the Fast Girl Skate start line is Beethoven's Fist going up against Melanoma.
Beethoven's Fist goes to the middle. Melanoma originally to the outside, cuts back to the inside. Spontaneous Combustia out of the penalty box and trying to push her jammer through the pack. Fearless Fritz up front trying to contain Beethoven's Fist as Melanoma is your lead jammer for the quad squad.
Yeah, Beethoven's Fist still out there, and she looks like she may get by. She's got Trucker at the front, or Turner at the front, sorry.
She gets dropped in the middle of the apex between turns one and two. Melanoma now already around the track, engaging the pack on a scoring pass. Beethoven's Fist still working on her initial.
Now Chucktown Bruiser knocking Beethoven's Fist out. She's on 6 trips already.
Chucktown Bruiser has been a force this bout for the quad squad, although so is Sia. Wouldn't want to be it for Jet City, who had the exit hit on Melanoma in the far straightaway. Beethoven's Fist finally clears the pack on her initial pass for Jet City. Melanoma clear for a full 5-point scoring pass for the quad squad.
And Beethoven's Fist just able to hold that line and get out of the pack. Hopefully be able to stem the bleeding for Jet City.
Well, Melanoma and Columbia not calling off this jam. They are going to continue to run it as we near 45 seconds left in this jam.
Again, time management coming into play. And with that 30-point gap, I think Columbia sees light at the end of the tunnel.
Melanoma now overtaking Beethoven's Fist. Melanoma may be content here just to play some defense and run out the clock. 25 seconds left in this jam will take us down to about the 6.5-minute mark. That looks like that's exactly what's happening here, Lou.
Yeah, and Beethoven's Fist just looking worn out by this game, by her travels. Finally gets around Melanoma again.
Melanoma looks like she may have a little bit more in reserve than does Beethoven's Fist.
Time's going to run out in this jam, Mike checks. And 5 points total, 10 points total, I believe, in that jam for Columbia.
I really like that Melanoma kept baiting Beethoven's Fist to get physical with her there, thus expending more energy. And we've got team timeout being called by Trail of Trash in Jet City.
And I'm wondering if that was going to go to an official review. No, I think just a timeout. This timeout will be brought to you by Jackson. Skate for the love of it. Jackson Skates. Find out about them at AdamWheels.com, too. A 30-point gap for Columbia. They've extended that out. We saw in the first half, very good at manipulating time in the game, making these jams. We just saw that in the last jam.
Right.
Very good at stretching these out. If they can get lead jammer and they're willing to do that, they can keep the number of jams left in this game to around 3.
Right.
So Jet City has to be worried about that.
Jet City has used 2 of their 3 timeouts. They have not used their official review in the second half. But as Lou said, if Quad Squad picks up lead jammer, they can, if they so desire, run that jam for 2 full minutes. And definitely limit the number of scoring opportunities for Jet City going forward.
And again, if you're sitting at home watching us on WFTDA.tv, you can go and check out the photos from the Viva Las Vegas Skates booth on the WFTDA Facebook page. VivaLasSkates.com is their website.
Jam is underway. Mama Wrecking Ball jamming for Jet City. Joy Wrecker jamming for Columbia. And is that a multiplayer block in turn one? It appeared to be that going against Star Stormer. And a multiplayer block up front now.
Everyone getting the multiplayer block in this jam, Mr. Checks.
That's Assaulted Peanut reporting to the penalty box now. And Joy Wrecker clears the pack. Lead jammer going to the quad squad.
So now the question is, what will they do with this lead jammer status?
Mama Wrecking Ball receives a big hit in turn two. Knocked out. She's going to have to reset. That was Holly Hunter.
She had a nice little breakdancing spinorama on her back after that hit, too.
Joy Wrecker clears the pack on a grand slam. 5 more points for the quad squad. Bomber wrecking ball going to have to get around Holly Hunter, and Holly Hunter again forces her to the outside as Joy Recker finds room on the inside to clear five more points. Quad squad.
It looks like Mama Wrecking Ball has something wrong with her skate. She's going to have to do that star pass.
Got to stay legal to be able to do it, though. And nice job of separation by Columbia right there, trying not to let her get to Beelzebabe. Beelzebabe, though, now with the star in her hand. She has cleared the pack on Jet City's initial pass.
It's a tough break by Jet City, but nice work by Beelzebabe to get out of the pack quickly. Four more points, and the jam's going to get called, so they're not going to run at the full, but they still manage to tick a whole bunch off of the clock. Four more points, two for Jet City at the end of that jam. 19-2, Columbia able to really exert their physicality at the end of this game. We still have four minutes, 15 seconds remaining.
Trying to see what was up with Mama Wrecking Ball's skate there. She was having a hard time staying upward. And we have an official timeout down on the track.
Hey, we should talk about a new generation of roller derby. Rolline, proudly made in Italy. You can find out all about it online at roll-line.it. And, of course, IT standing for Italy. Yeah, that was a really tough break for Jet City. Skate failure resulting in a 19-point jam. Columbia was doing a good job of containing her in the pack, but you always hate to see those technical problems being something that causes the gap to get that much bigger, especially near the end of the game.
That's right. You see Coach Trayla Trash there working on Mama Wrecking Ball's skate at the end of the Jet City bench there while the track is being worked on, so lucky as far as that goes.
And again, if you want to talk to us or talk to other people watching this, hashtag talk2WFTDA on the Twitters. And we are down to 4 minutes and 8 seconds remaining in this game. The 5-second mark is issued, and the jam's underway with Poison Violet and Wonelli on the line.
Poison Violet slowly trying to work her way through the outside, gets moved to the in there. That again by Spontaneous Combustia. Wonelli, though, your lead jammer for Jet City.
That is exactly what Jet City needs, Mike Checks. They have enough time to come back, but they need to put points on the board, and they need to do it quickly.
Poison Violet now out of the pack for the Quad Squad. Quad Squad looks like it was trying to race this pack. They are now down to two blockers on the track. Well, now make it three as Mal Pacino leaves the notorious RED penalty box and rejoins play on the track. Oh, and Chantilly Cream slides down and takes out C. Wouldn't want to be in the backfield.
Poison Violet with some nice hustle at the end of that jam. Picks up 2 points for Columbia, 3 points for Jet City. We're just checking to see if Chantilly Cream is all right. She's taking herself over to the EMTs. We will get the next jam underway. Score 130 for Columbia, 84 for Jet City with 3 minutes remaining in this game. Give a shout out to Powerhouse Skates.
And back on the track, that's Melanoma jamming for the Quad Squad. Ava Durche jamming for Jet City, and it's Ava Durche lead jammer. Jet City, two lead jams in a row.
Down by 46 points. They need to hustle. They need to close this gap so they can make that final push with only 2 minutes and 40 seconds remaining in the game.
Well, there will be time left on the clock at the conclusion of this jam, even if it goes the full 2 minutes. Holly Hunter out of nowhere recycles up, knocks Ava Durche out. No pass, no penalty, as Holly must have gone out of bounds. Ava Durche clears on a 5-point scoring pass. Quad Squad clears on their initial.
Yeah, you know, even though she didn't force that track cut and 5 points were scored by Jet City, that last-ditch effort still slowed her down long enough, allowed her own jammer to get out of the pack, able to clear things. Chantilly Cream is okay. That is good. She's back on the bench. Those 5 points makes the score 130-89, 41-point differential with about 2 minutes remaining in the game. We're going to get a timeout, I believe, as time ticks down. Yes. I like when the coaches come out and they stand in front of the head ref say, I'm not calling it yet, but I'm going to be calling it, so just be ready.
When I working with Rob Lobster back in the day, one of his things would be he would go out to the head ref and say, can I get a timeout at 29 seconds? That way he could come back to the bench area, and some head refs would allow that, some
nice,
would not, but
nice.
It made things easier, so not surprised to see that at all.
Yep. Now, also, he waited until, and I don't know if it's specific, but he waited until they were under the two-minute mark.
Right.
The Columbia coach did. And that means if they get lead jammer with a 41-point lead, they're more than willing to trade points for time for the victory.
Well, but the one thing they do need to keep in mind is that this is postseason play. And it there is. Are rankings points on the line here as well. So, you know, they do have to temper one thought with the other. Of course, the immediate goal being advance.
Yes,
the
indeed.
Secondary goal being let's look to 2015.
Yeah, I mean, Jet City used their Division II playoffs to vault themselves into Division I.
Right.
Ending up in 30th place at the end of June 30th. This could be the last jam of the game, Mr. Chex.
That is Ivana Hurtcha jamming for Jet City Poison. Violet jamming for the Quad Squad. Ivana Hurtcha now pushing up against the front of the pack. Quad Squad deciding to go all defense right now. Ivana Hurtcha, one left to beat up front. She is clear. Lead jammer goes to Jet City.
That's what Jet City needed. They cannot afford to let Columbia to get lead and kill the clock.
Beethoven's Fist now reporting to the notorious RED penalty box for Jet City. They are down one blocker. Ivana Hurtcha on a scoring pass now. One to beat up front. She is clear. That is 5 points. Poison Violet choosing not really to engage the pack much. Does not want to get a penalty. Pushed to the outside by Morticia Militia.
She was also getting the stare down by Nasty Nikki Nightsticks, who gives her a bump as well, so you got to wonder if she doesn't want to deal with that.
Poison Violet now clears on her initial pass. Ivana Hurtcha now working on clearing the pack on another scoring pass. Instead, calls off the jam. Already had gotten her 5 points. Jet City one shy of the century mark.
Yeah, a 10-point jam, 99 for Jet City, 130 for Columbia. They get the clock stopped at 40 seconds using their final timeout. They still have their official review, 31 points separating the teams. 31 points is a lot to get in a single jam under the 2014 rule set, Mr. Chex.
That is true. 30-second power jams make that much more difficult. And since the Quad Squad is going to start this jam with the jammer on the track, you now have to create a penalty to get the jammer penalty, and then you only get a 30-second power jam.
Yeah, your other hope being that your defense can lock down on Joy Wrecker, who is going to take the cap for the Columbia Quad Squad, and Wonelli taking the star for Jet City. They are back out on the line with still 10 seconds left in this timeout. Quad Squad getting the back line. We'll see if that will work out in their favor.
Worked out for them many times this bout. The nice thing is we're going to start with an empty notorious RED penalty box to start this final jam.
So
or what likely will be the final jam.
That's right. Columbia looking to book their bout against Rose City at 8 p.m. Jet City trying to ruin that with 39 seconds remaining in the game.
Joy Wrecker starting out, going to the end, moves to the middle. She is clear. Lead jammer goes to the Quad Squad. Whoa, Nelly recycled back into turn one. Ooh, big hit by Poison Violet.
And the bench of the Columbia Quad Squad telling Joy Wrecker not to engage. We saw last week, very dangerous to engage.
Right.
You can end up losing a game right at the end. Sometimes the fans don't like this, Mike Chex, but it's good strategy.
Well, with a 31-point lead and lead jammer, Whoa, Nelly still trying to get through the front of the pack. Gets around Poison, gets around Hunter. She is clear on her initial, and that's enough for the Quad Squad to call it off.
No points on that final pass, but that does not matter. The final score, unofficial final, but I don't expect it to be changing. 130 for Columbia, 99 for Jet City. Columbia will get to face Rose City, a team you are somewhat familiar with, Mike Chex.
Just a little.
At 8 p.m., which is going to be an interesting test of their strategy considering the firepower that Rose City brings to the track.
That is absolutely right. Gutsy performance by Jet City early this morning, fighting off travel woes, some possible jet lag, but they put up a heck of a performance against the Quad Squad. Quad Squad taking their victory lap now, well earned.
So Jet City, if you're a Jet City fan, you will see them tomorrow facing off against the loser of the next bout. The next bout, of course, being Philadelphia, the Liberty Bells, taking on the Boston Massacre. the 4-5 matchup. Gonna be some sparks in that boat too.
There are some great bouts still yet to come today.
Oh,
yes. A Friday full of Derby. And Derby that you should be watching or listening to. So thank you all for joining us on WFTDA.TV. I am Mike Checks.
I'm Captain Lou Obama. We've got Atlanta and Naptown out at 4 o'clock.
That's right.
Again, schedule has changed. So if you are looking at something that you saw before today, it has changed because of these delays. So next game, Philly versus Boston. After that, Atlanta versus Naptown. After that, you've got Victoria facing off against Madison, Mad Rolling Dolls.
Right.
And then the grand finale, Rose City, the Wheels of Justice, trying to make their way back to champs, taking on the team we just saw win, the
Columbia Quad Squad All-Stars. Yeah. Do we have penalty numbers for this bout?
Penalty numbers, there was a whole bunch of penalties.
There were.
Let me see.
We did not see anybody pick up seven, though.
Nope. Chucktown Bruiser was the closest at six. And other than that, generally a pretty clean game. Only two jammer penalties by Columbia, four jammer penalties by Jet City. Six jammer penalties in a Division I playoff is pretty
darn
minimal.
Good. That's yeah,
right.
Exactly.
Could explain why we had such a low score. So, again, congratulations to Columbia. Jet City, you'll be playing tomorrow. And we're going to go over for an interview, Mr. Checks. I believe we have Holly Hunter being interviewed by Inspector Muffin.
That's what it looks like down
there.
All
right.
Hey there, I'm Inspector Muffin for WFTDA-TV. I'm here with blocker extraordinaire Holly Hunter from the Columbia Quad Squad. Holly, the last time we were on camera together, the conversation had a different bit of a tone to it. It was after last year's Division I playoff. You guys went 0-3. You all were a Division II ranked team that got bumped up into the Division I playoffs. You're now a legit D1 ranked team. What were the feelings going into this tournament rather than last year?
We were a little disappointed last year. Grateful to make it, but we wanted to be a little bit closer or pull out a win. So we reevaluated at the end of the year, and this year we wanted to come as the top 40 team and win one. So we have achieved our goal.
That was an incredibly physically bout to watch. Where does that one stack up physically in your career?
That one was pretty up there. The only one I can say is Kalamazoo. Those girls hit really hard too, but that was definitely a physical game.
Prior to 2013, Quad Squad didn't really play in many multi-bout weekends, going to tournaments like ECDX or Brouhaha. This year you all played in two. You guys played in the Southern Discomfort, and you all played in Frankie Panky. How do those multi-game weekends now come into playing into your stamina for playoffs?
It definitely helped us prepare. I don't know if that is going to translate into this evening when we face Rose City, but we've definitely worked on endurance and tried to get a lot of games under our belts, multi-bout weekends.
What can we look, fans look, as you for the rest of this weekend? You did say you're going to play Rose City tonight at 8 o'clock, a tall order for someone that's already played a bout today. What do you see yourselves going forward as a team?
We're just going to play as a team, do what we practiced, and see how we stack up, do our best.
Holly Hunter, Columbia Quad Squad, great blocker. Up next, you've got Philly and Boston. I've been Inspector Muffin. You're watching WFTDA-TV.
It is definitely not a leisure lifetime activity, and so I definitely feel wrapped up in like the nowness of it and wanting to go 100% right now while I can physically. And I just can't imagine that I'd get more kicks like playing golf than I do hitting a feels good. Hi, I'm Scald Eagle. I play for the Rose City Rollers Wheels of Justice, and S1 is part of my uniform.
When you don't buy Antic skate boots, you buy some other brand. When you buy some other brand, you suck at practice. When you suck at practice, you're unprepared for Team Antic USA skater Carmen Getsum. When you're unprepared for Carmen Getsum, she destroys you on the track. When she destroys you on the track, you end up on the trainer's table with a concussion and major injuries. Don't end up with a concussion and major injuries. Buy Antic skate boots.
My name is Lacey Knight, and I skate with the Angel City Derby Girls. I've been evolving more and more into just having things that I know are going to be reliable that they're going to last, and that they're going to do exactly what I want them to do. When you've reached a certain place in your derby career, it becomes less about how much you're spending on the equipment as it is about what it's going to do for you. I need to be able to have it conform to my foot so that it's just an extension of who I am as opposed to this thing that is now on my foot. The Rydell boot that I have now has been able to successfully do everything I need it to do. This year has even gotten better for me, and my skating is the best it's ever been, and it's the best boot that I've ever had.
You're watching WFTDA.TV.